Hello friends, welcome back. In this tutorial, we will study about recurrences. A recurrence is an equation or inequality that describes a function in terms of its value on smaller inputs. Right? When an algorithm contains a recursive call to itself, then its running time can be described by a recurrence. Right? Now see, when an algorithm follows a divide and conquer approach, then it divides the original problem into several smaller sub-problems which are similar to the original problem, right? Then it solves these sub-problems recursively. When an algorithm contains a recursive call to itself, its running time can often be described by a recurrence, right? Now let us discuss a recurrence for the running time of a divide and conquer algorithm, right? Now suppose there is a divide and conquer algorithm, right? And it solves a problem of size n, right? Let tn be the running time of this divide and conquer algorithm on a problem of size n, right? If n is small, it means when n is less than or equal to c for some constant, right? Then straightforward solution takes constant time, which we write as theta 1, right? Now see, for example, if we have to sort only two elements, then it will take constant time because one comparison has to be performed to sort these two elements, right? So when the size of a problem is small enough, right? When the value of n is small enough, right? Say n is less than or equal to c for some constant c, then a straightforward solution will take constant time, and which we write as theta 1, right? But if this size of problem is not small enough, right? When the value of n is not less than or equal to c, right? When the size of problem is not small enough, then what will happen? Divide and conquer algorithm will divide this problem into smaller subproblems. Now suppose this algorithm divides this original problem of size n into a subproblems, each of which is 1 by b, the size of the original problem, right? Let dn be the time to divide the problem into subproblems, and cn is the time taken to combine the solutions of the subproblems into the solution of original problem, right? So what is dn? Dn is the time taken to divide the problem into subproblems. And what is Cn? Cn is the time taken to combine the solutions of the subproblems into the solution of the original problem, right? Now, each subproblem is of size n by b, right? Each subproblem is of size 1 by b of original problems. So, its size is n by b, right? Now, each subproblem will take time tn by b to get solved, right? Now, here there are a subproblems, right? So, it will take a tn by b time to solve these subproblems, right? Now, see. Now, the running time tn of the algorithm on a problem of size n is given by this recurrence, right? When the value of n is less than or equal to c, right? Then the running time of algorithm will be equal to theta 1, right? When the size of problem is small enough, right? Then the running time of algorithm will be theta 1. But if n is not less than or equal to c, right? Then the running time of algorithm on problem size n will be equal to the time required to divide the problem into subproblems, that is dn plus time required to solve all subproblems, that is a dn by b plus time required to combine the solution of subproblems into the solution of original problem, that is cn, right? So when n is not less than or equal to c, then the running time tn of the algorithm on a problem of size n is given by a tn by b plus dn plus cn, right?